tired of flying, Jan. Wendy, is it much farther?
Just a little farther, Michael. I can see our house way down below.
Get on my back, Michael. I'll carry you the rest of the way.
Open and unbarred. Peter was wrong.
Oh, it's so good to hear our cuckoo clock again.
I think I've been here before.
Michael, it's your home, you stupid.
I had nearly forgotten. Who's that lady asleep there in a chair?
It's Mother. Oh, dear Mother. There are tears running down her cheeks even while she sleeps.
Let's creep up and put our hands over her eyes.
No, let's break it to her gently. Get into your beds. Quickly, she's stirring.
I see them in their beds so often in my dreams that I seem still to see them when I awake. I'll not look again. So often their silver voices call me, my little children whom I'll see no more. Oh, Wendy, Wendy.
Mother.
Again I seem to hear Wendy. 'Tis folly to even turn my head, she's never there.
Mother.
Now it's John's voice.
Mother!
Now, Michael. And when they call, I stretch out my arms to them. But they never come. They never come.
Oh, Mother! We're back! We're really back!
My children! Wendy, John, and Michael! Oh, my darlings, my little ones! George! George, up here! They've come back! Oh, my own, my precious own children!
Oh, I just can't believe it, Wendy. It's the strangest tale.
Oh, but we can fly, Father.
Would you like to see? We'll fly out the window.
Oh, no. We believe you, darling. We believe you.
Well, if it went for all those little boys on our doorstep, I still wouldn't believe it. Mary, what on earth are we going to do with them?
Those poor lost boys. George, I think we should adopt them.
Oh, Mother, I knew you'd say that. I'll call down for them to come up.
Wait, Wendy, wait. Mary, my dear, where will they sleep?
Oh, we'll put up beds for them in the drawing room.
That's exactly what I told them, Mother. Father.
Oh, very well. Call them in, Wendy. But no flying in through the window. You know the neighbors. They'll have to come in the front door.
Children, come in. Come in, all of you. Mother and Father are going to adopt you.
Yeah! Oh, Mother, Father, come quickly. There's Peter.
Where?
Where, Wendy?
Where?
There, flying over the park.
Peter! Peter!
Oh, yes, indeed, I see him.
Oh, the naughty is knocking off the hats of the elderly gentleman as he flies by. They must be getting very cross at him, Wendy.
Oh, no, they can't see him. They're too old. You can't see Peter if you're old, you know. They probably think he's a draft at the corner.
Peter! Peter! Oh, he can't hear me. I must fly out and talk with him.
No, Wendy, no!
Wendy, come back! Come back!
I'll be back! I'll be back soon! Peter! Peter, wait!
Hello, Wendy.
I'd like to talk to you.
Well?
Can't we sit down for a moment, Peter, here on this roof?
All right.
Peter, you don't feel you'd like to say something to my mother about a very sweet subject?
No, Wendy.
About me, Peter?
No.
Oh, Peter, my mother is willing to adopt you.
Would she send me to school?
Yes.
Then to an office?
Oh, I suppose so.
Soon I'd be a man.
Very soon.
I don't want to learn solemn things. No one's going to catch me and make me a man. I just want to be a little boy and have fun.
You'll be lonesome without the boys, Peter.
I shall have Tink.
If you like, I'll come once a year to do your spring house cleaning.
Goodbye, Wendy.
Goodbye, Peter. Peter, you won't forget me, will you? Please, Peter. Please, don't forget me!